I bought this Koplin, it's called a Throttle Master for Bunny's Honda Recon 250, because the factory lever is actually hard to press, you know, being, you know, new spring and everything. And if you're riding for a little bit, you know, your thumb does get tired. So this just clamps on, and it has a real wide paddle, and it has a soft rubber grip on it, and you're getting a lot more leverage. So it's really easy to use. Your thumb doesn't get as tired, and we both like it a lot. She loves it. The only thing I had to do is I had to move all this down, because this was right here at the end of the grip, which means this would have been way out here. So you'd have to hold the grip like this to be able to hit the end of the throttle. So just move everything down and it's perfect. Like I said, we both like it a lot, but I do not like the thumb lever, the thumb throttle on ATVs. I prefer the traditional motorcycle twist type throttle. So I just, oh, by the way, this was January of 2023. It was like $19 on Amazon. So I'm gonna show you what I just bought for my ATV, and then we're gonna do a real quick install on it, and I'll give you my thoughts on it. Koplin Handy Throttle. So you just take your factory grip off, and there's a sleeve that goes in here, and then this slides over the sleeve. It's only four parts. And when you twist the throttle, this lever actuates on the OEM throttle lever, and there you go. Remove your grip, slide on the collet, or as they call it in the instructions, a bushing, and the lips will spread, and that'll give it a nice snug fit. No comment. Then you're gonna slide your handle on with the throttle actuator, and this is nice because it is like super snugly. You slide this on, so you're just gonna get a good lineup and see where it works. I mean, that feels like it works great. If I went all the way, geez, that's even smoother. So I'm gonna keep it like that. Typical poor instructions. It shows these pieces laid out like this, and it doesn't specify which direction it goes. It's like this, because inside here, there's a tab. You can't see it, but you can feel it. And it goes into this notch. So what that does is it stops the throttle there and here, so it can't spin in circles. Now make a mark on this, because this has to move down, because this has to slide on first, and then this inner sleeve has to slide in. You can't put the inner sleeve on because, sorry, I don't have a tripod here. You can't put the inner sleeve on because this won't go on. It doesn't slide in that way. There's a stopper inside. This has to go on first and then the sleeve. But with this on, you can't get this on here and spread this open. So you have to slide all this down. That'll expose just a little bit of the end, and then you could put it on, and then look, I can almost do it with one hand, and it'll go on, and then you just tap in with a piece of block of wood and a hammer. Hope you fully understand. If not, watch it again. So I'm just gonna mark this with a putty knife, and now I have a little chit there showing me where it goes. Chit, that is C-H-I-T, no S. You just push the outer sleeve in enough to give a little exposure here, and the inner sleeve, and I'm gonna use this as leverage right here, this little tab, and there it is. Got it on one-handed, yeah! Next, you're gonna move your little collet back to where it was, where you marked it on the handlebar, your little chit mark. And then you're gonna slide this forward, your throttle housing, and then tighten it up, make sure it's nice and level. The only thing you have to do Remember, we lined everything up with our chit, so we know this is going to fit. The throttle has the range up here, so I'm just going to turn it. Check where full throttle is, which is going to be here. So I'll just turn it, and that's full throttle right there. Slide on the grip. Lesson learned, do not repeat. Do not use the actuator for leverage. I could not get that rubber grip on. I even used oil and I almost had it on and I snapped the actuator. So now I gotta get a whole new kit for $44. All right, I got my new throttle and Amazon took the other one back. Hey pups, yeah, we're gonna get this done. Amazon took the other one back. I told them that it broke upon installation due to brittle plastic, so no problem. So let's go ahead and catch up to where I was and finish this little project. All right, I'm installing the new outer sleeve. To reiterate, so you do not break this arm, what I would suggest is hold the throttle at full, right there, and then I'm gonna turn this down. I can't do it on camera because I don't have my tripod here. I'm gonna turn this down until this arm just barely touches the throttle when it's at full. And that's gonna set the end point. Lots of dripping lube when you put on the grip. I use Ballistol because it does not degrade rubber or plastic. So I'm smearing it on good. And when I work on that grip, do not hold the actuator as leverage. I'm just gonna like pinch it like this and work that grip on and we should be good. When I was putting the grip on, I realized that there's play on the outer sleeve. So this is gonna be a little bit out of order and I'll show you how to eliminate that and then back to the grip. You're gonna have a little bit of play in the outer sleeve. So all you have to do is, if you can see that, here's the outer sleeve. So I'm gonna put a wide flathead screwdriver on there and just tap it in and that's gonna eliminate all that play. Ta-da, ta-da! I'm gonna try it out, okay. So I just gave it a run around the perimeter and wow, it's awesome. It is so nice and you have so much control and it's great being able to grab the grip and not have your thumb out like this that I'm sure even though I just put that lever on for Bunny, when she tries this one, I think she's gonna like it. I think she's gonna want one too. It is really, really nice. And it's like, it transforms. You feel like you're on a totally new machine. It's just such a more pleasant experience. So I hope you enjoyed. Until next time, take it easy. Oh, and here's Hensky. He wanted to say hi. Hensky, he's my buddy. And when I get lost in the woods, he guides me back out. He's a good guy.